Good day mga kahabi. Kung baguhan kayo sa channel na to, again, please po subscribe sa aking channel. Hit the notification bell para kayo updated sa ating mga upcoming videos. And of course, please do like this video. So, for this week guys, we are going to present to you yung ating iba-ibang uri na mga goldfish, different types of goldfish na makikita sa ating bansa at sa ibang bansa na rin. So, guys, samahan nyo ako to let you know kung ano yung mga iba-ibang uri ng goldfish. So, let's watch the video. Guys, our feature for this week is all the types of goldfish. Now, let's go to Oranda. Ang Oranda is ang klase ng goldfish na merong prominenteng bubble-like hood sa ulo. Ang head growth ng hood ay napaka-prominente na ito ay nasa ibabaw ng ulo ng isang Oranda goldfish at pwede niyang i-cover ang buong mukha except ang mata at ang ilong. Next is the fantail goldfish. Ang fantail goldfish ay nagpo-possess o nagtataglay ng malaitlog na hugis ng katawan. Merong high dorsal fin at merong quadruple caudal fin at walang shoulder hump. Magkakatulad sila ng ryokin na makikita natin mostly sa western countries. Next is ang comet or comet-tailed goldfish. It's a single-tailed goldfish na nabred sa United States. It is similar to the common goldfish except slightly smaller and slimmer and is mainly distinguished by its long, deeply forked tail. Ryokin goldfish. Ang magandang Ryokin goldfish ay isang Japanese version ng fantail goldfish. Sila ay dinevelop galing sa common fantail goldfish. Kagaya ng kanilang fantail counterpart, they are one of the more rounded or egg-shaped fancy goldfish. Now, yung Ryokin goldfish ay makikita atin kaibahan sa fantail because of their extremely high back, which is often described as a dorsal hump. Yung hump nagsisimula sa neck region and gives a more pointed appearance to the ryokin's head. At they also have a wider caudal fin than the fantail. Now, ang pinaka makapag-distinguish na kaibahan na common sa dalawa between fantail and ryokin is their split or double caudal fin. Next, ang common goldfish. Itong common goldfish, ito yung makikita natin palagi sa mga pet shop, pet store na binibenta sa murang halaga. And they are mostly sila yung pinagsisimula naman ng mga breed ng iba-ibang goldfish. Now, the Blackmore goldfish. Ang Blackmore goldfish is galing sa veil tail variety and has an overall black coloration. Ang Blackmore variety have metallic scales. All goldfish are members of the carp group and are generally quiet hardy, kagaya ng Blackmore. Shubunkin. Ang shubunkin ay similar lamang sa common goldfish and comet goldfish pagdating sa anyo or appearance. Una silang nabred sa Japan by crossbreeding the Calico Telescopic Eye Goldfish, Comet Goldfish, at ang Common Goldfish. Now, they have streamlined bodies with well-developed and even fins. Shubunkin Blue is the most prized color sa lahat ng Shubunkins. The Bubble Eye. Ang Bubble Eye ay isang variety ng maliit na fancy goldfish with upward-pointing eyes that are accompanied by two large fluid-filled sacs. It is a dorsal-less fish. Good specimens will have a clean back and eye bubbles that match in color and size. Yung bubbles sa kanilang mukha ay napaka-delicate. So the fish should be kept separately from boisterous types as well as sharp tank decor. Ang Rancho or Carassius auratus ay isang fancy goldfish type na bred sa Japan. They are one of the oldest fancy goldfish. They are also called the king of goldfish by the Japanese as they are highly prized, with some selling for hundreds of dollars. Sila ay na-develop galing sa lionhead variety and are distinct as they lay as they lack any dorsal fin. Yung scales are metallic and come in a wide variety of colors from white to black. Next, the lionhead goldfish. The lionhead goldfish is by far ang pinaka-popular at mas kilala na dorsal-less goldfish. The lack of stabilizing dorsal fin is a trait that is also seen in the bubble eye and the celestial eye goldfish. Unlike the common goldfish at na mga shobonkins, which has a long, slender body, the lionhead is also one of the more rounded or egg-shaped fancy goldfish. Veil tails. Veil tails have stout, balloon-like bodies with a depth of at least two-thirds of the length. Their long, flowing caudal fins are delicate and translucent, have no apparent forks or lobes, and should be at least three-quarters of the length of their bodies. Their dorsal fins are single, but all other fins are paired, and their caudal fins should be well divided. Next is pearl scale. Ang pearl scale, ang karakteristik niya ay meron siyang thick dome scales with pearl-like appearance. Yung katawan niya ay round and similar sa isang golf ball. Ang finish may be long or short. Pearl scales can reach up to 8 inches long and grow up as large as an orange. Yung pearl scale goldfish ay susceptible sa swim bladder disorders, which affect the ability to maintain normal position in the water. They are also known as the ping pong pearl scale and golf ball pearl scale. Pompom. Ang pompom ay may kagayang hugis ng katawan at finish ng isang lionhead or oranda. But instead of supporting a head growth, it has nasal outgrowths. The extent of the nasal outgrowths, which are enlargements of the nasal septum, vary in pompom goldfish. Yung pompom may have metallic or nacreous scalation and can occur with or without a dorsal fin. Next is the butterfly tail. Ang butterfly tail goldfish ay isang variety ng goldfish which is kilala as butterfly telescope. Ito ay nanggaling sa China at native sa Chinese goldfish that was brought sa Japan in the early 1980s. It is easily distinguished by the butterfly-shaped caudal fins when viewed from above. This variety has only recently been deemed a major lineage by a few published works.
Next,
the tusakin. Although it has a body shape similar that of other fan-tailed goldfish, its tail fin opens and spreads flat and wide horizontally, with the leading edges flipping under once or even twice. Because of that, the tusakin is a weak and even clumsy swimmer, requiring it be kept in still water without a strong current. Ang tusakin ay minsan napagkakamalan as a weak fish due to inbreeding. However, in reality, it is hardy as most other breeds of fancy deep-bodied goldfish. Like many other deep-bodied goldfish, the tusakin is especially prone to swim bladder disease. Next is the telescope eye. Ang telescope eye is a fancy goldfish characterized by its protruding eyes. Ito ay na-developed noong 1700s sa China, where the trait was referred to as dragon eyes. Except for the enlarged projecting eyes, the demikin, another term for telescope eyes, is similar to the ryukin and fantail. It has a deep body and long flowing fins, some with veiled fins and some with broad or short fins. like the China doll. Demekins are available in red, red and white, calico, black and white, chocolate, blue, lavender, kirin, chocolate and blue, and black coloration. Sila ay maaaring merong metallic, matted, or nacreous scales. Telescope eyes can grow quite large. Next is ang lion chew. Ang lion chew or lionhead run chew, isa sang uri ng fancy goldfish na nagresulta from crossbreeding lionhead and of course yung run chew. Next is the red cap oranda. Ang red cap oranda is a particular species of goldfish and like all other goldfish, originally descended from carp. This attractive little fish has an oval body shape like an egg and metallic looking scales for a bit of shimmer. Red caps have white bodies and a bright red growth atop their heads called a wen. Red caps also boast long, flowing white tails and fins that fan out beautifully when the fish stops swimming. These fins are attractive and make everything identifying red cap fish easier. Because of their similar coloration and wens, red caps are often mistaken for lionhead goldfish. Lionhead have no dorsal fins, however, and red caps do. Next is the shukin. Shukin for a body shape like long type of rancho, but it also has a long tail fin like the oranda. Shukins comes in red, red and white, white, blue, and silver. The shukin is a rare type of goldfish na na-developed sa Japan, although the breed is becoming popular sa US with advanced hobbyists right now. Next is the Izumo Nankin. The Izumo Nankin is a rare species of goldfish. They are hardly ever seen outside of Southwest Japan. They are not as hardy as other species, so they are difficult to ship. This is largely why they are so rare. It is difficult to purchase them because they will very likely die in transit. Next is the Tamasaba or Sabaw is an uncommon Japanese variety of goldfish with a body shape similar to a ryukin or a fantail but with a long flowing single tail that is similar to that of a mackerel. Hence, its other name, mackerel tail. This attractive and strong goldfish variety makes a very suitable pond fish and aquarium fish. Usually, white and red Tamasaba is rarely seen with other colors. It withstands the very cold weather. The Tamasaba originated from the Yamagata Prefecture in northern Japan.